Hello, this is Frontline here, and welcome back to 7 Days to Die. This is a series that I've been doing here, and I think it's honestly a pretty fun of a series. We've been trying to explore, if you're wondering. We need to go around and basically find what wasn't a furnace, we need a forge. A forge is what we need, and that will allow us to get iron and be able to smelt a bunch of stuff. So, really, we're going to need to find some sort of forge here soon. I mean, we technically can make one, but we need a bellows. I just saw that. Oh, man. You guys were probably screaming at me, being all like, that's a deadly radiation zone you're going into right now. And I almost did that. I did not mean to pause the game. I just want to put up the map. So apparently we like went right around, and right in this area here is a deadly radiation zone that we do not want to go to. We'll just probably continue on this road the other direction instead. It's also started raining. It doesn't seem to be raining that much. Yeah, now we're in the desert, so it completely stopped raining. And now we're completely dry. So, yeah. Honestly, I thought I headed this way on the road before. But yeah, now that I remember in the last episode, we actually came from that direction that way. So now we're going this way. I thought I saw an animal, like, poking its way, like a prairie dog or something, over in the distance. But yeah, I'm getting sidetracked. There's a zombie in our way to follow this road. Huh, it'd be nice to get a vehicle in this game at some point. I think you're able to get a minibike, but you also need, like, a cement mixer or something like that will be able to make you create different parts for various iron vehicles and all of that. You also need engines. Engines are like a main thing that you need, and to get that you need wrenches, and I feel like they gotta fix this. They gotta like fix it so that cars like this don't look like this. This is not how a car works. But, you know what? I'm going to ignore it for now. Let's just continue on the road. We're still technically undetected, as I saw when I was crouching there. Although that could change with, like, the zombies that seem to be surrounding this road. I'm also collecting a lot of yucca plants. I don't know what they're good for, but I'm just going to get a bunch of them. I'm still undetected. Alright, that guy still hasn't seen me. I've been meaning not to sprint right near him, so hopefully he hasn't noticed me in that sense. They've got very poor vision, so I'm able to pretty much just go past them really easily. Looking back, I realized that I actually left my bedroll in that house. But, yeah, I think I actually meant to do that, but the main thing is that I'm going to have to eventually create another bedroll at some point, so we'll see when we actually are able to do that, but that's definitely a plan for the future. We need to get a base started. We need to find a forge, like we were saying before. Huh, didn't realize the roads converged here. Let's try to pull up the map. Yeah, it feels like that goes right into the radiation zone, just judging by where that direction is. So I'm going to continue on this road. I'm hoping we find a forge. It's like this would be a very unsuccessful episode if we didn't, because honestly, the main thing I want to do is explore. The main thing I want to do is explore. And it seems like there's a bunch of crawler zombies over there. We need to go around that whole entire area. Even though I really want to search those cars, I feel like it's not worth it at this point to do so. So hopefully we'll be able to go undetected, keep sneaking around, make sure that no little zombies find me. So yeah, I'm also seeing in the corner of the screen there that apparently I'm also getting very hot. So I might need to take off some of my clothes, but I'm not entirely sure how that works. So, I mean, It's still a pretty good temperature, 94. I mean, I experience that temperature like every summer, but yeah, it's like once it gets to 100, I'm thinking we'd get a little high of temperature. I mean, not actually high, but more hot. That was the word I was looking for. I was just all like, we'd be getting a little bit high. It's like, no. Oh, that was a bunny I was looking at. That was a bunny. I saw it that time. I saw a bunny. And there's a chicken, or a rooster, or something. I also see a base. I'm not sure if this is part of, like, the campaign I'm supposed to be after, or what. Because I'm here now. I followed the road. Now I'm kind of more at the center of the map. I know that there's, like, a little bit of a story to this game. Like, you can use... I'm pretty sure that guy sees me. Yeah, hunted. I think there's a little bit of story to this game in that I should use my wooden club, because it's actually a weapon and not a tool. Because the main thing about this is that, like, there's this pack of people you can meet and all that, and, like, you are trying to prove yourself to them in various tasks and, like, come live with them in their little secluded area. And this might be the secluded area. There's also mini bike wheels. Yeah, I might be able to get a mini bike at some point. Alright, so... I don't know what to expect here. I'm almost not sure if I'm walking into a trap. I mean, there is a zombie there. There is a zombie there. I am overheating now. Yep, I thought that. I was thinking, like, once it gets to 100, I'm thinking that then would be the time that I start. Rocket! Ryan. Okay, I'm bleeding out. I'll use this bandage to stop it. I can't go anywhere. Use this bandage. Run. Run basically forever. I'm not going back there. I am not going back there. I see a dog chasing after me. But hopefully we'll be able to outrun it. I'm not sure if we will. I think it's slower than me. So hopefully we'll be alright. I was... I didn't want that. And I don't know if there's anything of use in there. I'm honestly not sure. I should get out my bow. Because I crafted that earlier and never put it into my inventory. Okay, is anyone, like, coming towards me? Alright. So I think I'm actually thirsty at this point. I'm not sure. But... yeah, water's at 43. I'm going to drink a little bit, and hopefully that should get down my heat a little bit. Maybe? I don't know. I don't know how these mechanics work. I'm just heating up more. I'm going to, like, take off some of my clothes again. Let's take off the shirt. Take off the pants. Nah, we'll leave that on for now. If we keep overheating, then we'll take off more clothes. But for now, I think we should be... all right. So anyway, we found another random house. There doesn't seem to be many zombies around here. I hope there's no zombies around here. It seems like it's kind of like the house that we found before. Like, pretty much nothing inside of it, nothing of use. Yeah, this is just pretty uneventful so far. Really wanting to find a forge at the moment. Is this entire place desert? Like, I swear, when in this campaign world, I thought that, maybe I'm not in the campaign world, or, well, maybe I'm not in the same campaign world. Maybe, like, it is naturally generated weirdly. Yeah, we'll just keep on this path. We kind of went around here. I think this whole entire area is desert. So hopefully if we keep traveling upward, like, in this road, we'll be able to find something. But at this point, I'm actually not sure. I don't know if, like, randomly generated terrain is, similar to, this game. Like, I don't know. I kind of like the world I was in before. I'm going to have to take this really quickly. And bam, okay. So I like the world I was in before, but this doesn't seem like the world I was in before. I did the same exact thing. It's not randomly generated. I'm just kind of traversing like I am. Okay, there's a tiny house there, but I'm betting there's no really good supplies there. Although I'm not sure. I'm not sure if I should check that house. It takes a while to check these cars, which is kind of realistic, I will admit. But I don't know. I really want to continue. Is this another radiation? No, it's not. I like was seeing green and automatically think radiation, but that right there is a random patch of not desert for some reason. Maybe it is desert. Maybe it's just like some fertilized area. Anyway, not much has happened this episode. It's already 3 o'clock, it seems. And, like, it's middle of the day. And, oh man, I am really overheating. I was not paying attention. So, how about let's, like, go quickly here. Take off our pants. And hopefully that will solve our problems. I'm not sure if it will. But I'm just hoping. I'm going to continue on this path. This seems to be going in a little bit of a different direction. So yeah, let's explore the desert. How big is this map? That's the one thing I really want to know. Because the thing is, in Minecraft, the world size is limited because of the space you can store on a hard drive. So the main thing about this game is that if it takes up a lot of memory, the map can't really be that big because each save file has to be a certain size. Alright, so we found a gas station, which might help us, but the problem is there's a lot of zombies that are kinda hard to take out. I need to reload. I really hate how it doesn't automatically reload for you. Sometimes it's like with a gun, it makes sense that it's like, yeah, you really should reload whenever you need a new clip. But with a bow and an arrow, you should just be able to like use your bows automatically. I am experiencing heat stroke. So, I don't know, I don't think I'm going to take on all these guys. This is taking too much. I'm also realizing that I'm also a lot slower, probably because of the heat stroke. So yeah, I'm just going to like back off a little bit, take off another piece of clothing, although I don't have much to take off at this point. My water solution is really low, though. It's the one thing I can say. I really need to get out of this desert. It's like, I'm not sure if those little green patches are oases. Like, I'm just able to be safe over there. But as of right now, I am just really hot and need to get out of here. I need to rest somewhere, but the problem is zombies are chasing me, so I can't rest. And, yeah, it's kind of a problem. It's like the main thing to stop heatstroke is to rest, and I can't rest. And my water is almost out. I might have to just, like, drink the murky water. I don't know if that's, like, a bad thing, which it probably is. It probably is a bad thing to drink the murky water. But honestly, at this point, it might be better than not having anything at all. Okay, which way on the map are we heading? If we head down that way, we should, like, I don't know. My heat keeps going up. I don't know how I'm supposed to cool down at all. So yeah, we're just going to go really slowly. And maybe we'll be alright, but I don't know. And there's a house. I mean, we found stuff. We finally found stuff. But we're still in a desert. I'm surprised how big this biome is. I'm really paranoid around here. I feel like There's no easy way to go into this area. Also, there are zombies spawning on the roof, which is kind of hilarious, in all honesty. They just go up onto the roof. Looks like someone's already seen me. I'm going to have to go up this hill. Let's just go a little faster, even though I'm not supposed to sprint. I have to. Let's just throw away our plant fiber stuff. Let's get the bottle of murky water, drink that. Of course. You must rest, find water, or you will die. Alright, let's just drink all of this. Okay, I'm only experiencing stage one now. So yeah, I've drinking all of the water that I can at this point. So now I just gotta continue on, avoid these guys. My temperature's going down, which is very, very promising. Still gonna collect these bird nests. I think I've been missing some of the bird nests, but at this point it's like somewhat I can't do all of them because of the things following me. Alright, so this is going to be an interesting series. I am still deadly afraid that this will turn into another situation like the previous game. Oh, I don't even have any stamina. That's not a good thing. It's like I'm not going to have enough stamina to actually do anything. Is this door locked? Yeah, it is. Okay. Let's just try to break it open, if we can. Is that guy following me? I swear he just like ducked around the corner just as he saw me, like, oh, whatever, you don't need to die today. But yeah, it's almost nighttime, so really I got to settle down here. Man, I'm sensed. I'm actually not being hunted at the moment, which is surprising. I'm gonna quickly go here. I'm still sensed. Alright. I'm gonna like quickly type in a door so I can like craft that real quickly while I do this. Okay, so there's nothing really in here. We'll build a wood door. And that's it, I guess. If there's no zombies in here, we'll stay for the night because it's almost nighttime. Apparently, goggles? Yeah, because if you see the time in the top, it's like, we really don't have much time. What's in this room? I'm curious now. It's like boarded up. I'm going to have to like get a axe again. I can hear the zombies, and it's not nice to hear that. Oh, wait a minute. I was, like, thinking really weirdly. It doesn't become actual nighttime until 10 o'clock. So, really, I've still got another 40 minutes. Although, the time is slowly ticking away. So, we found schematics to make a leather hood. That's pretty cool. Wait, what? I picked up the TV and didn't really think about that. Oh, dang it. My wellness just went down. I don't know why. But, oh man, it's so dark I can't see. Well, oh, it's dysentery. That's the reason. Stamina, minus one every 1 second. That's sad. Works for 35 minutes? Ah. I don't even have, like, any herbal tea or anything to, like, help me with that. 35 minutes? That's the whole entire another episode. Ah. Go have dysentery for an entire episode. Alright, well, let's just focus here. The main thing we need is bedroll. That's a good thing to think of. So, what was I really going to get? Torches. That was what I was going to really get. Because I can't see. I literally can't see. I don't know where I'm facing right now. My TV brightness isn't bright enough for me to know. Okay, well, I know that I can place down a bedroll here. So I'll do that, I guess. And now let's get some torches, because torches are probably... Actually, can I get torches? I don't think I have coal. Because I can't do a candle, and I can't do torch. Because I need tallow. I don't know how to get tallow. I wish you could skip the night. That would be really helpful. Do I even have, like, a torch of some kind? I should have grabbed a candle. If I had a candle, then I would have been able to see. I placed down, like, my one torch inside of the one house. Got gunpowder, but that's not coal. It's like... I literally don't know what to... Oh, campfire! I don't have stone. Okay, there's the TV. Okay, there's the TV. If I turn 180 degrees, that should be the door, technically. Yeah, I use door. I really can't see. How am I overheating already? Come on. Ugh. This is a terrible situation. I mean, okay, I paused the game. I don't have any way to make anything that makes light. If I had a campfire, that would be amazing. But apparently I threw away all of my rocks. I don't want to go outside to collect any rocks, because that would pose a lot of problems, just judging by how I can hear zombies every waking moment right now. I mean, I'm still only sensed, so it's not like I need to worry too much. Okay, how about let's work around the house by getting a block of something. Can I place down wood? No, I can't. How about let's get a, let's create a frame of some sort. Let's just go into the basics, create a wood frame, craft that. It'll go right here. Boom! I can see the ground, kind of. So up here is the TV, I'm thinking. Right there is a couch. Empty bookcase. Oh no, that's the TV. That's the TV. So that means that around this corner is other stuff. It's a wooden chair. Only a sound effect just played now. I'm not sure if that means that nighttime actually doesn't start at the time I thought it did. Maybe it had to do with, like, some other thing. I literally can't see, guys. I'm sorry. I literally can't see. There's a chair. Just trying to inch my way around here to see if there's anything I can get. Ooh, trash can. Nothing. Pile of garbage. There's something. Candy tin can. Is there anything I can just, like, throw away that I know I won't need? I mean, rotting flesh, as much as you might think that rotting flesh I might not need it, but I think it can be used for fertilizer. I think it can be used for fertilizer, but I'm not 100% certain. Oh, by the way, while I was, like, looking around and made, like, a cut in the video, I found a wrench. So now we can repair things a lot faster. But the main thing I want to use a wrench for is to actually, like, disassemble cars. Because that way you can get an engine, and you can get, like, a concrete mixer, I believe. And that should be able to, or a cement mixer is probably the correct term. But do I have food? I only just realized my food situation I haven't been looking at. Let's just eat something. Like, let's eat this. Hunger went up a little bit, and eat a can of salmon. My thirst went down a little bit with that, though. Could just drink the alcohol. I mean, I think it can be used for something else, but that'd be nice if I could just drink that and call it good. Want to hear any campfire stories? I'm kind of running out of ideas here. Am I undetected now? Yeah, I'm undetected, but I still can't see. So how about we go on like a little campfire story? So there's this one bear in the woods, and he is Bigfoot. How about let's make it more interesting? It's not just a bear in the woods, it's Bigfoot. So Bigfoot is in the woods, and two campers by the names of Jerry and... I'm just looking around the room to find some names. Jerry and Ronaldo. So Jerry is a resourceful person. He says that we should capture Bigfoot. Was that Jerry I was talking about? Okay, so Jerry is the resourceful person. Ronaldo thinks that they should have no say in trying to find Bigfoot and that they're very well off just in their campsite doing nothing. So he wants no part of it and goes ahead and says, you know what? I can see. You know what? I can see. Well, it's really weird to just be able to see all of a sudden. This is the house that I was just navigating by this little wooden frame. I'm surprised that no zombies came in to hurt me, honestly. That was nice. Everything just got darker again. But yeah, okay. How about we just not finish that story? Because we knew, everyone knew, that that story was not going to be a very good one. So they captured Bigfoot and everything was good in the end, except Ronaldo learned his lesson for not trusting Jerry. I think I didn't mix up my characters. I normally, like, try not to mix up my characters. Cooking pot! I found a cooking pot! It just got darker in here again. But I just found the cooking pot. That means that in a campfire, I can actually, like, cook murky water. I wanted that cooking pot so long ago. I couldn't get it. Alright, so I'm technically sensed. I'm gonna repair this door. I think there's nothing else in this house that I need. Empty pile of garbage. I checked everything, got the wrench. In here, did I check it, everything? Yeah, I checked everything. So yeah. We're just going to open this door, let these guys on in, and dodge them by going around here. There we go. Ah, that was a good night. That was a good night, everybody. So, that's the end of this episode because it's been a day. I hope you enjoyed the story of Jerry and Ronaldo that had to be cut short because I didn't tell the story soon enough. We're going to continue off in this direction as we do the outro because I do not want to be anywhere near that guy. I almost kind of want to check the rest of the place, but at the same time, I'll see what I do in the next episode. But that has been all from me. I'll see you guys next time. Bye. We'll be right back.